In this video, we will show you the support and resistance trading strategy for beginners that is simple yet powerful approach. And your trading approach will never be the same after knowing this secret. Not knowing this support and resistance secret can be the reason you will spend years failing. After watching this video, you will learn how to use market support and resistance to trade and avoid market trap like a professional that took us years to discover, which not many people talked about. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and hit the notifications bell so that you know exactly when new content is released. Also, let us know your questions and thoughts below or video topics you want us to cover, as we always take your comments into consideration and love hearing from you all. Support and resistance levels are horizontal price levels that typically connect price bar highs to other price bar highs or lows to lows, forming horizontal levels on a price chart. A support or resistance level is formed when a market's price action reverses and changes direction, leaving behind a peak or trough swing point in the market. Support and resistance levels can carve out trading ranges like we see in this chart, and they can also be seen in trending markets as a market retraces and leaves behind swing points. Price will often respect these support and resistance levels. In other words, they tend to contain price movement until, of course, price breaks through them. In this chart, we see an example of support and resistance levels containing price within a trading range. A trading range is simply an area of price contained between parallel support and resistance levels, like we see here. Price oscillates between the support and resistance levels in a trading range. Note that in this chart, price eventually broke up and out of the trading range, moving above the resistance level. Then, when it came back down and tested the old resistance level, it then held price and acted as support. The other primary way support and resistance levels are created in a market is from swing points in a trend. As a market trends, it retraces back on the trend, and this retracement leaves a swing point in the market, which in an uptrend looks like a peak and a downtrend looks like a trough. In an uptrend, the old peaks will tend to act as support after price breaks up past them and then retraces back down to test them. In a downtrend, the opposite is true. The old troughs will tend to act as resistance after price breaks down through them and then retraces back up to test them. Here's an example of a market testing previous swing points, support, and a downtrend. Note that as the market comes back to test the old support, the level then behaves as a new resistance and will very often hold price. It's wise to look for an entry point into a trend as it comes back and tests these previous swing points, because it's at these levels that the trend is most likely to resume, creating a low-risk, high-reward potential. So, if you are enjoying the video and found it helpful, please leave a like on this video and a comment, as this goes a long way and helps support our channel. We appreciate it. So let's get back to it. Support and resistance levels are a price action trader's best friend. When a price action entry signal forms at a key level of support or resistance, it can be a high probability entry scenario. The key level gives you a barrier to place your stop loss beyond, and since it has a strong chance of being a turning point in the market, there's usually a good risk-reward ratio formed at key levels of support and resistance in a market. The price action entry signal, such as a pin bar signal or other, provides us with some confirmation that price may indeed move away from the key level of support or resistance. In this example chart, we see a key level of resistance and a bearish fakey strategy that formed at it. Since this fakey showed such aggressive reversal and a false break of the key resistance, there was a high probability that price would continue lower following the signal. This chart shows us how to trade price action from a support level in an uptrend. Note that once we get a clear pin bar buy signal, actually two pin bar signals in this case, the uptrend was ready to resume and pushed significantly higher from the key support level. And this chart example shows us how sometimes in trending markets, a previous swing level will act as a new support or resistance level and provide a good level to focus our attention on for price action entry signals. In this case, the trend was up, and a previous swing high in the uptrend eventually flipped into a support level after price broke up above it. We can see that when price came back to retest that level the second time, it formed a nice pin bar entry signal to buy the market and re-enter the uptrend from a confluent level in the market. Finally, the last chart we are looking at is an interesting one. Note the swing low that occurred in the downtrend on the left side of the chart. You can see how this level stayed relevant months later, even after the trend changed from down to up. It first acted as a resistance level after price broke down through it. But once that resistance was broken, we had an uptrend form, and then after that, that same level acted as support. And that's where we see the fakey pin bar combo signal in this chart. Now, if you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful, please show your support by hitting the thumbs up button, subscribing to our channel, and turning on the notifications bell so that you can keep up to date with new content releases. Also, leave your questions and thoughts below. If you want to know more about trading and investment, you can check out our website, fxtradinger.com. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.